Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Today I will teach you Social Science of Grade 7, Chapter 6, Mughal Empire, Golden Age and Downfall. Let's start the chapter. Jalu family went on a tour to Delhi. Palak gave the album of snaps taken during tour to her class teacher. He showed it to the students. One question was written under each picture. Looking at one of the pictures, students asked the teacher a question. Why is this lady in the picture pulling the chain of the bell? The teacher answered that this picture gives a glimpse of the system of justice during Jahangir's period. We will get information about different Mughal rulers today. After the death of Akbar, the most powerful and influential ruler of the Mughal dynasty, Jahangir ascended the throne of Delhi. The Mughal kingdom was extended far and wide during this period. There was peace in the state. After him, during Shah Jahan's reign, many monuments were built. Many of these were world-famous monuments of unparalleled magnificence. During his reign, the Mughal dynasty was stabilized. Later on, during Aurangzeb's rule, the empire extended, but it led to the fall of the empire too. Let us learn about some major incidents that occurred during Jahangir, Shah Jahan and Aurangzeb's period. Students, with a view to provide justice for all, the Mughal Emperor Jahangir had hanged a golden bell in the balcony of his palace. The chain of the bell was hanging down the balcony. Any citizen could seek justice from the emperor by pulling the chain. Jahangir's love for justice is famous in history. The emperor was the chief justice. Qazi-ul-Quzzan was the minister for justice and looked after the judicial administration in the empire. Qazi, a judicial officer, was appointed in every suba, sarkar and pragana. The judicial functions were performed by the gram panchayat in the villages. Jahangir, 1605 to 1627. After the demise of Akbar, his son Salim assumed the name of Jahangir, which means conqueror of the world, and ascended the throne in 1605 CE. Prince Khushru revolted against him and so Jahangir imprisoned him. Jahangir accused Sikh Guru Arjan Singh of helping Khushru and so sentenced him to death. During Jahangir's reign, Hawkins and Thomas Rowe visited India as representatives of the King of England and sought permission to trade in India. Jahangir's wife, Nur Jahan, was very beautiful and ambitious. Most of the administrative work of the empire was handled by her. Students, Akbar was the most powerful among the Mughal rulers. His son, Prince Salim, assumed the title Jahangir, which means winner of the world, and he ascended to the throne after the death of Akbar in 1605 CE. Jahangir put down the revolt of Prince Khushru and imprisoned him. Jahangir beheaded the Sikh Guru Arjan Singh, accusing him of helping Prince Khushru's revolt. Sir Hawkins and Sir Thomas Rowe, the representatives of King of England, visited Jahangir's court and sought permission to trade in India. Jahangir's wife Nur Jahan was very beautiful and ambitious. She handled most of the administrative work. Shah Jahan, 1627 to 1658. Shah Jahan believed that agriculture is fundamental to the prosperity of a nation. So he gave primary importance to agriculture and continued with Akbar's land revenue system. He appointed honest and hard-working officers. Shah Jahan established a new city near Delhi and named it Shahjahanabad. He constructed many grand buildings there. In comparison to others, the Mughal Empire's income and revenue was more during Shah Jahan's reign. Shah Jahan constructed world-famous monuments like the Taj Mahal, Diwan-e-Aam and Diwan-e-Khas in the Red Fort, Rang Mahal, Moti Masjid, Jama Masjid of Delhi, etc. Students, after Jahangir, Shah Jahan ruled the Mughal dynasty from 1627 to 1658 CE. Shah Jahan considered agriculture as the pillar of prosperity and he gave much importance to agriculture. He continued the revenue system developed by Akbar. He also appointed honest and hard-working officers. He developed a new city called Shahjahanabad near Delhi. Mughal dynasty earned higher revenue during Shahjahan's period compared to the period of the other rulers. Shahjahan was famous for constructing grand buildings. He constructed world-famous Taj Mahal, Diwan-e-Aam and Diwan-e-Khas in Red Fort, Rang Mahal, Moti Masjid, Jama Masjid in Delhi, etc. Under Shahjahan, the Mughals witnessed the Golden Age. Aurangzeb, 1658 to 1707. Aurangzeb's memory was extraordinarily sharp. He was well versed in the Arabic and Persian languages and had studied the Quran-e-Sharif in detail. Aurangzeb disliked art, music and painting. Veer Durgadas waged a prolonged war with Aurangzeb for 25 years in order to free Marwar. Aurangzeb also fought against the Shia states of Bijapur and Golconda in the south for 25 years. In Maharashtra, Shivaji established the Maratha kingdom in South India and had constant conflicts with Aurangzeb. The Jats and the Sikhs too revolted against Aurangzeb. After Shahjahan, his son Aurangzeb ruled the Mughal dynasty from 1658 to 1707 CE. Aurangzeb had a very sharp memory. He was very well versed with Arabic and Persian languages. He also did in-depth study of Quran-e-Sharif, the holy book of Islam. He disliked art, music and painting. Mughal dynasty expanded even more during his rule. Later, it also started falling during his rule. Brave Rajput leader Durgadas fought with Aurangzeb for 25 long years in order to free Marwar. Aurangzeb fought for 25 years with Shia states of Bijapur and Golconda in South also. Shivaji of Maharashtra established the Maratha power in South India and constantly fought with Aurangzeb. Jats and Sikhs also revolted against Aurangzeb. After knowing about some of the incidents that occurred during the rule of Mughal emperors Jahangir, Shahjahan and Aurangzeb, now let us learn about their social life and administration. Social life. Society was based on the feudal system during the Mughal era. The king and his courtiers led a life of pleasure and luxury. The emperors and amirs were fond of expensive clothes and jewelry. Abul Fazl has written that about 1,000 expensive garments used to be made for the emperor every year. During this time, Gujarati traders conducted business on a large scale and large volume of goods were imported and exported from the ports of Gujarat. Festivals were celebrated with a lot of pomp and grandeur. During Jahangir's reign, Dashera was celebrated in a grand manner. Foreigners did not have the right to take away wealth from India. Students, during the Mughal period, feudal system existed in the society. The kings were involved in worldly and sensual pleasures. The kings and amirs liked wearing gaudy clothes with lots of ornaments. As per Abul Fazl, a history writer, 1,000 expensive clothes were stitched every year for the king. During the Mughal period, businessmen of Gujarat had huge businesses. Large number of goods were imported and exported from the ports of Gujarat. Festivals were celebrated with grandeur. During Jahangir's rule, Dashera was celebrated in grand manner. None of the British traders had permissions to take away wealth from India. Economic condition. We can know about the economic condition prevalent during the Mughal era from Abul Fazl's book. At that time, 55.5 ratal was equal to one man, which was the old units of weight. Shawls from Lahore, duris from Fatehpur Sikri, cotton cloth from Gujarat and Dhaka's muslin were very famous and popular products. Goods were exported and imported from Kambat, Surat, Bharuch and many ports of Bengal. Villages were self-reliant at that time. Villagers themselves produced most of the goods that they required. Students, the economic condition during the Mughal period is well described in Abul Fazl's book. At that time, Ratal was the unit to weigh things. One Ratal was equal to one score, that is, one score is equal to 20 kgs today. Villages were self-reliant, and so villagers produced almost all the necessities they required. Shawls of Lahore, duris means mats of Fatehpur Sikri, cotton clothes of Gujarat, and muslin cloth of Dhaka were famous worldwide. Students, muslin is a lightweight cotton cloth in a plain weave. Goods were imported and exported from ports of Kambat, Surat, Bharuch, Malabar, and Bengal. Art and literature of the Mughal period. The Mughal rulers were very fond of grand palaces. Hindu style of architectural decoration merged with Islamic style of constructing palaces and domes. Shah Jahan built many renowned monuments and is known as the constructor of palaces. He also patronized many artists and so encouraged art. The Rajput rulers were very fond of paintings and so patronized the art of painting. Jahangir too was fond of collecting paintings. Students, during Shah Jahan's reign, there was peace within the empire. His encouragement to agriculture and trade meant more income for the citizens as well as the state. There was also increase in the foreign trade. The treasury was flooded with the money that he inherited from his father as well as grandfather. He utilized this money for the construction of the monumental architectures. Shah Jahan was a lover of art and architecture. He was fond of building grand and beautiful buildings. He had built many beautiful buildings in Delhi, Agra, Kabul, Kandahar, Kashmir, Lahore, and Ajmer. He had built the Red Fort in Old Delhi. Within this fort, he had built a new city and had named it at Shah Jahanabad. In the Red Fort, he had built Diwan-e-Aam, Diwan-e-Khas, Rang Mahal, and Sheesh Mahal of Mumtaz. His royal seat, Mayurasan in the Diwan-e-Khas, was a bejeweled beautiful piece of art. He built Jama Masjid in Delhi and Moti Masjid in Agra. On the banks of River Yamuna in Agra, he built Taj Mahal in the memory of his wife Mumtaz Mahal. This beautiful architectural monument is a tourist attraction. He was also very fond of gardens. He got built a developed Shahi Bagh in Ahmedabad. For building these monuments architecture, Shah Jahan was known as the constructor of palaces. The Mughal era is considered to be a peaceful period on the whole. It was a favorable time for the development of literature and Sanskrit books were translated, historical volumes were written and Hindi literature received patronage. The Dohas of Kabir and Rahim and Sakhi became famous. Ras Khan, a disciple of Vaishnav Acharya Vithal Nath Ji, composed Hindi poetry. Many foreign travelers came to India during this period. They have described the state administrative system and the common life of the people in their travelogues. Two French travelers, Tavernier and Bernier, visited India during that time. Of them, Bernier lived in India for 12 years. He has observed that Mughal rulers used to spend a great sum on the army. He has also mentioned appreciatively that Indian textiles were very famous in the markets of Europe and Asia. Students, there was peace during the Mughal period and so literature developed quite well. Sanskrit books were translated and several historical books were written. Also, Hindu literature got good support. Dohas of Kabir and Sakhi of Rahim became famous. Ras Khan, a disciple of Acharya Vithal Nath Ji of Vaishnav community, composed Hindi poetry. Many foreigners visited India during the Mughal period. They also described administrative system and social life of people of India in their travelogues. French travelers Tavernier and Bernier also visited India. Bernier stayed in India for 12 years. He mentioned that Mughals spent too much money on the army. He also appreciated that Indian textiles were very famous in the European and Asian markets. Think, in the present time, what percentage of the budget is allotted for the army in our country? The answer to this question is, almost 4 lakh crore is spent on the army in our country. Number 2. Why are short verses like Doha and Sakhi popular among people? Students, a Doha and Sakhi composition is of 4 verses. People can easily memorize and sing these verses. These compositions are emotional and the words are catchy. They deal with the themes of love, bravery, sacrifice, morals, martyrdom and bhakti. These popular themes are composed in the folklore form and language, which is easy to understand. Downfall. Shah Jahan's reign can be considered as the golden age of the Mughal Empire. One can say that the downfall of the Mughal Empire started in the later years of Shah Jahan. Aurangzeb's policies too proved fatal. Aurangzeb struggled continuously. Among these, the conflicts with Veer Durgadas in the north and Maratha Kesari Shivaji in the south are noteworthy. Students, Aurangzeb's narrow, short-sighted, fanatic and intolerant policies led to discontent in many parts of the Mughal Empire. The militant and self-respecting Jats, the Sikhs, the Rajputs, the Satnamis and the Marathas revolted against the Mughal Emperor. The Shia Muslim rulers of Bijapur and Golconda became his enemies. Aurangzeb spent most years of his life fighting against the Rajputs and the Marathas. The constant warfare emptied the royal treasury. Due to these reasons, the decline of the Mughal Empire started during the reign of Aurangzeb. Veer Durgadas. After the demise of the King of Jodhpur, his queen and her son were under the threat of Mughal rulers. Veer Durgadas sheltered them at a safe place. After that, with the help of royal soldiers, he protected Marwar's independence for 25 years. Aurangzeb was unsuccessful in dealing with their strategy of launching surprise attacks and had to ultimately reconcile with the Rajputs. Students, Veer Durgadas was the Senapati of Maharaja Jaswant Singh of Jodhpur. After the demise of the Maharaja, there was threat of the Mughal to the queen and her son. Aurangzeb wanted to convert the prince to Islam. Durgadas provided them a safe shelter in the Aravali Mountains. Thereafter, he protected Marwar from the Mughals with the help of the royal soldiers. He adopted guerrilla tactics and harassed the mighty Mughal army. This struggle went on for 25 years. Ultimately, Aurangzeb had to reconcile with Veer Durgadas. Veer Durgadas is famous in the history as the protector of Marwar. Chhatrapati Shivaji. As a consequence of Aurangzeb's policy, many kingdoms revolted against him. Maratha's kingdom was one amongst them. The Maratha Sardars who worked for the Bahamani Sultans enjoyed jagirs, that is large land holdings. But the need to establish an independent and strong Maratha kingdom arose with the emergence of Shahaji Bhosle, the brave and capable leader. Later, Shivaji Maharaj, his son, took over the mantle of the Maratha kingdom. Shivaji Bhosle was born in 1630 CE in the Shivneri fort. He was raised by his mother Jijabai and mentor Dadoji Kondev. He dreamt of establishing a small and an independent kingdom at Pune. He inherited his self-respect, fearlessness and brilliance from his mother and learned the intricacies of administrative policies from the grandfather. He was fortunate enough to have a good friend like Tanaji. Gradually, he expanded his army and at the tender age of 16, he started capturing forts. Torana, Chakan, Sihangad, Purandar were some of the forts captured by him. Shivaji was coronated in 1674 CE after several confrontations with the Sultans of Bijapur and the Mughals of Delhi. He worked hard to establish a smooth and efficient administrative system. He formed a cabinet of 8 ministers for the proper administration of the state. Students, Shivaji was born in 1630 AD at Shivneri Fort in Maharashtra. Shahaji Raje Bhosle, a jagirdar in the service of the Sultan of Bijapur, was his father and Jijabai was his mother. He inherited self-respect, fearlessness and brilliance from his mother Jijabai. He dreamt of an independent state, Hindavi Swaraj, from his childhood. He was molded by his mother and teacher, Dadoji Kondev. At a tender age of 16 years, he laid the foundation of his Swarajya by capturing the Torana fort. Thereafter, he captured Chakan, Purandar, Singhad, and many other forts. After many confrontations with the Sultan of Bijapur and the Mughals, Shivaji was coronated at Raigad in 1674 AD and assumed the title of Chhatrapati. Thereby, his independent kingdom was established in Maharashtra. He formed a council of 8 ministers for the proper administration of his state. End of Mughal rule. The Mughal army was tired of waging war against the Marathas in the south for 25 long years. At last, Aurangzeb decided to retreat towards the north. He had also become old by that time. After his demise, the decline of the Mughal empire began. Struggle for the throne broke out. There was no capable ruler who could keep everybody together. Aurangzeb's narrow-minded policies were responsible for the end of the Mughal empire. The Mughal Empire, which was established in 1526 CE, started declining from 1707 CE. The empire set up by Babur extended over most of India in Aurangzeb's time, and during his reign itself started declining. Discuss about the Mughal Empire on the basis of the points given in box 6.7. Students, the great Mughal Empire, which was set up in 1526 CE, started declining from 1707 CE. Mughals were tired of fighting with the Marathas in the south for 25 long years. At last, Aurangzeb retreated towards north. He was quite old then. After his death, the Mughal Empire started declining in India. After Aurangzeb, the Mughals started fighting for the throne. None was capable of handling the large empire properly. It is also believed that narrow-minded policies of Aurangzeb was also the reason for downfall of the Mughals in India. Read and discuss. From among the Mughal rulers, who extended the empire the most during his reign? Students, the maximum expansion, that is extension of the Mughal empire, took place during the reign of Akbar. During whose reign did the downfall of the Mughal Empire begin? Students, the downfall of the Mughal Empire started during the reign of Aurangzeb. With the reference to the picture given alongside, describe Shah Jahan's condition in the last days of his life. Students, in the picture we can see Shah Jahan had fallen sick in 1657 AD. Taking advantage of this situation, Aurangzeb captured the throne of Delhi by treachery. First, he defeated his three brothers and then put his father Shah Jahan under house arrest. In this picture, Shah Jahan is resting on the bed and from the balcony watching Taj Mahal, which he had constructed in the memory of his beloved Begum Mumtaz Mahal. Students, here we end our chapter 6. Mughal Empire, Golden Age and Downfall. Students, if you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe the channel Asma Babwani. Click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. Like the videos, share the videos and do comment on all the videos.